Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech. And every year, Apple releases a new version of iOS and releases a bunch of betas and then releases the final product in September. Now, we start to see rumors about it and about what devices are supported and things like that early in the year. And usually a lot of those things are true since developers are working on them. There's early versions of them, things like that. And we'll see the first version of it in June at the Worldwide Developer Conference, or what's known as WWDC. This is usually in the first or second week of June, and then they release the beta the same day they show it off. So we'll have beta one then. But I wanted to talk about what this year's version of iOS will be all about. And I've talked about what I'd like to see in it, but this year will be all about refinement. And then I'm also going to talk about what devices will be supported since we have some more information about that. Now, the first thing is every other year, it's sort of a TikTok cycle, as many people call it. There will be a feature release and then a refinement release. This year is a refinement release. So for example, 2 years ago, iOS 12 came out, and what we had with that was minor features, but major refinement. So for example, they tweaked the performance. They gave us screen time. They gave us grouped notifications with iOS 12. They gave us Memoji, group FaceTime, the Measure app. There were some small tweaks to photos. There were some Siri updates. They released the Shortcuts app, but they didn't integrate it until iOS 13. There was a small Apple News update, a Stocks redesign, a bedtime feature for Do Not Disturb, a small Maps update, but that was to the background of Maps in general. And then there was also some air quality index added to the weather app. So all of these things were small updates for the most part. And then with iOS 13, they brought in a bunch of features, but with a bunch of bugs. So just a quick recap, they improved performance by 2x supposedly. They also introduced dark mode. So we have dark mode if you want to make your menus dark. I actually have it go from day to night, so it changes based on daytime and nighttime. There's also a major photos redesign and a huge update to accessibility for those with the ability or inability to actually control their phone easily with touch, so you can use voice control. They brought Apple Sign In. They brought Find My to replace Find My Friends and Find My iPhone. They updated Maps in a major way. They also brought the Quick Path keyboard, which is basically like swipe. They redesigned Reminders. They redesigned CarPlay. They brought Apple Arcade. They also updated a bunch of languages for India and other places around the world, updated Files, Fonts, Health, Safari, Notes, Mail, and on and on and on. So with all of those changes comes a lot of bugs because software in general is just hard. And even though you might have hundreds or thousands or hundreds of thousands of people working on something, it's still difficult to nail down all of those bugs. So with iOS 14, Apple will bring the refinement that many of us have wanted with iOS 13, along with, I'm sure we'll see new features, but not a ton of them. But there is some great news for those of you, apparently, if this is true, there's some great news for those of you with iPhone SE, 6S, and 6S Plus. So the great news is, it appears iOS 14 will be supporting iPhone SE. It will also be supporting iPhone 6S and 6S Plus, if the source is accurate. So that means everything that currently supports iOS 13 on iPhone will be supported. However, on iPad, that doesn't seem to be true. It seems like Apple is getting rid of support for devices with the A8 and A8X processors. So what that means is this iPad Air 2 will no longer be supported, nor will the iPad Mini 4. So those are the current rumors or current information on what devices will actually be supported. But there will also be some refinements, meaning updates to things that are causing drain on battery life, updates to things such as problems throughout the OS with everything from Wi-Fi to Bluetooth to LTE connectivity. And hopefully with the next generation iPhone 12s, we'll see the Qualcomm modems come back, so we won't have the issues with LTE and cellular connectivity that we do today. Now, there are some things that a lot of people think may be in iOS 14. We're hearing some information about it, and there's quite a few desires that people want as well. And probably the number one thing that I hear has to do with phone calls taking up the entire display. So when you receive a phone call, it completely covers up the display. Many of you are familiar with this. Let me just show you quickly. Now, when you receive a phone call from another phone, just like I am here, you can accept it or decline it, but it's taking up the whole screen. If I double click the power button, I can go home and use the phone again, but it's really a pain. And it's something that is really annoying for a lot of people. On Android, it's handled a lot differently, and I would really like to see that refinement. So for example, let me show you that. So on my Pixel phone here, I'm calling myself. You'll see it says Aaron Zollo incoming call, and it just pops up on the top. I can keep using my phone while that's coming in. So it's one of those things that's strange that they haven't updated. Let me end that call. It's strange that they haven't updated that on iPhone. It seems like a simple enough solution that they could do, but it's not here. And hopefully we'll see it with iOS 14. Also, I would expect performance updates, more Siri updates, possibly new icons, but I would not expect a major redesign with iOS 14. Maybe they'll tweak some of the icons, maybe music or something like that. And of course, we'll have new wallpaper. Every year we have some new wallpaper, nothing major, but we do have them, and we'll have dynamic or stills or whatever they decide to do here. We'll just have new wallpaper in general, just like we do every year. And maybe we'll be able to place the icons anywhere we want, but I would not expect any major changes. Now, they could surprise us this year, but it's hard to say exactly what they're going to do. But the only current information we have about it is that it's going to be more refined. Apple's tweaked their process to make sure that software is more ready for the public, and betas are intrinsically buggy anyway, and that's what a beta is all about, is reporting feedback and things like that. But iOS 14 should refine everything, just like iOS 12 did, just like iOS 10 did. It's just the way Apple seems to do things. But let me know your thoughts about it in the comments below. Do you have an iPhone SE or 6S? And what do you think about support? I'm really excited. Apple seems to be supporting older devices even longer. So that's great news. So that means everything from 6S to the iPhone 7, the iPhone 8, the iPhone XR, 10, all everything from then on gets supported. So that's great. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.